Hello, everyone. I'm Ben. I work on a lot of different streaming technologies at Roku, all sorts of stuff for our smart TV platform. We have an office here in Austin, Texas, and we use lots of C++ in our code. So this talk, like every good lightning talk, started with a tweet. Error, stray slash 342 in program. This is what happens when you copy and paste from the H.265 spec. So you have to ask, why am I copying from this? Well, part of my job is dealing with a lot of closed captions. H.265 is a spec for 4K video. And when you're doing closed captions, you have to get the order of the pictures right, or else your caption looks like instead of like this. This is a problem which hopefully no one out there ever sees because we fix it before it gets to you. So, H.265 spec, much like the C++ spec, is a very complex beast. A lot of very smart PhDs working on this, and seems like their thought process is basically, I'm going to write all this code in C, oh, I have to make it English, let's convert it to English. So, here's a quote from a section that I was having to deal with. Slice, pick order count, LSB, specifies the picture order count, modulo, mac picks, count, LSB. Okay, I'm getting tired reading this. I'll come back to this in a moment. So, there's about 600 pages of this in the spec document. There's some tables, there's some nice figures, but it's a whole lot to deal with. Fortunately, I didn't have to deal with all of it. So the general algorithm here is you go through, you find the data structures, you paste it into your editor, you start converting it back from this English-like form into code. You have to basically, it's a random access document. Things get mentioned in one place, then get mentioned in lots of other places, and you have to find that one place to figure out. It kind of turns into this giant dependency graph. You know, you kind of have to build up, okay, did I resolve everything? It's like you're a human makefile at this point. So, I get to this point, and I compile, and I get the 342 error. So some of you might know where the punchline is here. So it's like, okay, what is this problem? 342? Oh, that's ecoctal. Okay, obviously. Convert that to hex, and wait, where do I get a circumflex A from? That's nowhere in the document. My code had a dash in it. Let me take you back to the previous thing. If you look there in the mac pick order count LSB minus one, that's where it came from. Yes. So, why does this not match up? UTF-8. Thank you, Kernigan. Hyphen is UTF-U plus 2010. So it's represented in 3 bytes. And GCC doesn't understand UTF-8. It'll gladly take it in comments and all, but you try to use it, it just goes, huh? So, you know, this was fairly easy to fix once I figured it out. In my research, I found lots of other characters to look for. Curly quotes, single quotes, M dashes, N dashes. If you look at the end of the line with non-breaking spaces, I listed them all for you. So, important thing is just be careful if someone ever edits your code in Microsoft Word. None of you would ever do that, but I've definitely had JSON files sent back to me that someone edited in Word. It's a bad thing. So, in the end, stray characters was just a very small problem. Getting the code working in the final form was a big thing. But it's working. We now have captions going for 4K content. And if you want to know more about the kind of fun stuff we're solving in C++ at Roku, please catch me on all the various usual channels, Slack and Twitter. Thank you all very much.